So, you like to become a film director, but just like everyone on YouTube, you probably don't want to go to film school, right? But what does a director actually do on set? And what is expected from you when you start directing?
And actie.
Now, when you first think about directing, you probably think about some guy sitting on a chair on set telling people what to do. But although this is one part of it, there's actually a lot more to it. As a director, your main task is to determine how a story is being told. This is often referred to as the creative vision. Now, this may sound a bit vague, so let's take a look at an example. Here I'm on set, directing a short promotional video for a car. The story is about an influencer that goes for a test ride to determine whether this car is a good festival cruiser or not.
Nou, het is elektrisch. Ik ben benieuwd hoe dat gaat rijden.
In the script we have written down all the scenes. Now people can play out a script in different ways, using different expressions, right? I can say this bit really, really sad. Or I can say this bit really, really happy. So how a script is played out determines the vibe in a scene and in the video. And as a director, you decide if the script is being played out well.
Ja, camera. En actie.
So on set, when an actor plays out a dialogue or monologue, I listen carefully and look at his expression. After the take, I give directions on how to improve the dialogue. But besides the dialogue, there's a lot more in the video that determines the creative vision. It also involves light, camera movements, frames, styling, and so on. And all these elements together determine how a film looks and feels. Now, on big sets, you will have crew that does light styling and all these things. And then it's up to you to determine if their work is according to the creative vision. Now, on a small set like this, there's only me as a director. That means that I also determine all these elements. In this case, I had a very good self-directing camera operator. So he knew exactly how things should look according to the script. But nevertheless, I start every scene by going over the camera position, angles, and so on. And after recording the dialogue, I also help directing the B-roll. Now in this case, I didn't need to focus on framing and stuff like that, but I did determine most of the camera movements to make sure the video kept the casual, loose feeling that I was looking for. So after the first scene of our video, we drove to a different location.
Ik heb mijn adaptive cruise control aan, dat is super handig. Zeker.
On our way, we decided to make some nice shots from the car driving. Now we didn't have time to install a car mount, so we went for a more guerrilla approach.
Gaat lekker, Jack. Ja. Gaat goed zo.
And in the car, I was giving directions about the speed of the car, and whether the car was isolated from other traffic. Now on the second location we did the same. Talked over the script and different angles and then started shooting. And at that moment I kept in mind what we shot earlier, so that this scene had the same vibe. So we shot 5 or 6 takes, and then again I looked and listened carefully. Now in the video, we worked with an influencer and liked to keep the dialogue as authentic as possible. So we didn't script out every word. Now, because of that, I also needed to keep an eye of the length of the dialogue. It's always hard to shorten dialogue in the edit without getting ugly jump shots.
We gaan even daarheen. Dan komen we heel hard aanvliegen met een drone. Steek ik mijn armen uit. En dan stap jij uit. En misschien dat je er nog een dikke reef voor jezelf van kan maken.
Even snel heen.
Zeg het maar, hè. Ja?
Now there's a big difference if you're directing small social content like this or a big feature film. But the one element that I think is crucial for success is to really know the vision that a script has and making sure it also looks like that on screen. Now this takes a lot of practicing, so I think starting with directing smaller productions is a great help. I hope this video was helpful. If so, let me know in the comments. If not, also let me know. And please subscribe to stay in the loop about more of these videos. Thank you very much for watching and good luck.